Hello everybody, I am Dr. Mrs. Mangal Dhent, teaching material science course of AC electrical class. Today I want to discuss one more experiment of material science course, development of tracks on insulating material. So for this experiment, test setup required for solid material testing and development of track is same. So general circuit diagram of HV testing, you know, it requires auto transformer. To the auto transformer, you will give normal supply available in the lab, single phase 230 volt AC supply. Then that auto transformer output you will connect to the secondary primary side of high voltage transformer through circuit breaker. And then secondary of high voltage transformer you will connect to the electrodes. Now in this experiments, electrodes you can take Rogowski electrodes or flat electrodes. Non-uniform field also can be used, but it can give breakdown voltage of insulating material immediately. And our interest is not to see breakdown voltage, not to find out breakdown strength, but just to observe tracks. So high voltage should be kept for higher time period on the insulating material. So it will better if you will take Rogowski electrodes. The material on which you want to observe track should be inserted between the two electrodes. Now tracks are generally developed on the layers of insulating material, and if you want to see treeing also, then it will require transparent insulating material. So usually for this experiment we are using polyester film, or you can take polyethylene, any transparent material you can use. So you can observe treeing phenomenon as well as you can observe development of the tracks. As usual, you can connect voltmeter to the secondary side if it is high voltage voltmeter, but we don't have high voltage, then you can connect it to the primary side, which will be calibrated in terms of the secondary side readings. So if you will connect voltmeter to the primary side, you can find out the readings of the secondary side by multiplying the ratio of transformer. So usually in our test circuits we are using calibrated voltmeter, so generally it is connected to the primary side. But as our interest is for high voltage side voltage, you can connect it to the secondary side, but it will require high voltage voltmeter, which will be costlier and also it will be heavy. So transportation movement of voltmeter will becomes heavier. That factors you have to remember. I am always telling, whatever is your answer, you must able to justify your answer. Answer is important, but justification is more important. Logic behind your answer is very important, and generally examiner observe how you think, what is your logic. Circuit breaker is required because when breakdown will occur, then circuit breaker should isolate high voltage from the electrodes. Our interest is not to observe breakdown voltage, still set test circuit will be same. Now before starting, I want to ask you one simple question. Write down this reflection spot question and then think it and write down answer. So what do you mean by tracking? Because unless and until you don't know tracking, what is the meaning of tracking or tracks, then you can't see what is the tracks developed and how they are developed and what is its significance. So what do you mean by tracking? Got it? Okay, track, it name only implies track. Track means road, it's the path for conduction, path for sparking. So tracking is the development of permanent conducting path, track, and EING. So it's a phenomenon of development of tracks. So tracking, you can define it as tracking is the phenomenon of development of permanent conducting path in the insulating material. So it's a process and it's a very longer process. It can take long time, but we are applying very high voltage, so it can develop immediately. Now before discussing about the tracking, again I would like to ask you one simple question, because you have performed this experiment already. Now you are preparing for oral examination. So on which material you observe tracks in your lab? Can you tell me which material was that? Whether it was brown paper or polyester film or oil or all, have you observed tracks on all these materials? I already told you that tracks will be observed in the transparent material very easily. Otherwise, then you have to take a microscope. So brown paper, no, you can't observe tracks and treeings also on brown paper. So we have used polyester film in our lab. Then second question, learning by doing exercise. You have learned by performing experiment. Again now today you also learn by doing, means you do it. Write down the answer in your notebook or at least think how to prevent tracking. So development of permanent conducting path. So it is a tracking. And treeing, you know, treeing means just a sparking in the fashion of branches of tree. So when spark occurs in the shape of branches of tree, it is called as treeing. So treeing is the phenomenon of formation or spreading of the spark channels in the shape of branches of tree. So when treeing occurred, you might have observed in polyester film, the treeing occurs first, you have observed it, and due to treeing, tracks are developed. So there is a damage or disturbance of the insulating materials due to the sparking, heavy sparking. And when you take out outside the polyester film or any insulating materials after treeing phenomenon for a longer duration, you can observe there are the tracks. It will be in the form of just scratches or black spots or black paths, which are permanent conducting path, because due to the sparking on that portion, that material has degraded its dielectric strength completely. So that is now permanent conducting path. And due to this phenomenon of treeing, tracking will go on occurring, and due to tracking, again treeing will happen. So it is simultaneous occurrence, and then it is a cyclic phenomenon. And after so many years, 2 years, 3 years, as treeing and tracking happens, go on continuing, there will be complete degradation of the material and complete bridging the gap between the two electrodes will occur, and that will lead to the breakdown of the insulating material. So it is just a longer phenomenon for the breaking down of insulating materials. Now how to prevent such a phenomenon? Tracking, by avoiding moisture, by using coating of track resistive materials, or by keeping surface clean and dry, or all you can use for avoiding tracking. Now this question is somewhat tricky. By avoiding moisture on the surface of the insulating material, you can avoid treeing, because if surface of insulating material will be moist or will have some dampness, then it will cause treeing. But treeing can lead to the tracking. So if you want to be specific for tracking only, then this avoiding moisture is not applicable because it is for treeing. Then by using coating of track resistive material, or keeping surface clean and dry. Again, by keeping surface clean and dry, you can avoid treeing, and then as treeing is avoided, then you can say it also avoided track. But if you want to be very specific for tracking avoidance, then you have to select option B by using coating of track resistive material. Because even if surface is moisture is there on the surface, then treeing can occur. But if material is coated with very high resistive material, track resistive material, then track will not develop so easily. So the option B is more correct. But if you have to justify with explanation, then you can say that all can be used to prevent tracking, because treeing subsequently can prevent tracking. So justification is very important. So I think you have understood no phenomenon of tracking and treeing. So what is the difference between treeing and tracking? Treeing is the spreading of spark channels on the insulating materials, and tracking is phenomenon of formation of permanent conducting path. So this treeing you can avoid by using avoiding moisture on the surface, keeping your ambience damp, clean and dry, and also surface of insulating material clean and dry. Whereas tracking can be avoided by coating very high resistive material. So treeing or tracking, it's the phenomenon which will lead to the breakdown of insulating material, and this breakdown phenomenon is a long time. It will take at least 2-3 years to damage the material completely. So I think you have understood now tracking. So thank you, and all the best for your exam. You can watch my other videos on the other